students, welcome again in a class of computer. Now last time we have learned about the primary memory of computer and its two types as RAM and ROM. Today we are going to learn about the secondary memory. The secondary memory is where the memory where data is stored permanently. This memory is a permanent memory as the content on this memory are not lost even after the computer is turned off. This memory stores a large amount of data, hence also called as backup memory. The examples of secondary memory are cloud storage, hard disk drive, pen drive, CD, DVD, etc. Now we are going to learn about the hard disk drive in detail. Now as you know, the hard disk drive is located inside the computer system. It is covered in an airtight sealed case. This memory is capable of storing large amount of information which is not portable. Portable means we can't carry the hard disk drive with us every time to carry the data with us. It is not working like as a pen drive. Pen drive, the data is called as portable, means we can carry with, easy to carry. We can carry with us everywhere. But that is not the thing with hard disk drive. It consists of inflexible circular platters which uses magnetic particles to store the information. Now we are going to look the working of hard disk drive. How that hard disk drive will work. Here I have shown you how it will look. The hard disk drive has many platters which are placed one over another. Now what is meant by platters? Platters is nothing but the plates on which we are going to store the data. Here the disk platters are shown to you. These are called as disk platters. There are two read and write heads on each platter. Here the heads are shown to you, and these heads are used to read and write data on the hard disk drive. The hard disk drive has arms that move the heads to the proper location of the platter whose data has been selected by the user. So disk arm is used to make the movement of disk head on disk platters to read and write the data. The read and write head mechanism reads and write items or files on the drive without touching the disk recording surface. Now let us learn about the common term that we are using with the hard disk drive, that is partition. What is meant by partition that we are going to learn in this section? Partition is nothing but dividing the disk into tracks and sectors so that data and information can be stored by the operating system on it. Now here I have shown you the diagram of one platter which is getting divided into different tracks and sectors. Now in this diagram, the track is nothing but the area which is shown with a red color. A track is nothing but a narrow band in a form of circle which is located on the surface of the disk. And sector is nothing but the combination or group of tracks at one location. That is considered as a sector. Now this partition will also able to make us to install two operating systems on the computer system. The first partition is called as C drive, where the operating system is installed and stored, and after that the drives are named as D, E and F respectively. Now let us move to the next secondary storage space, that is a cloud storage. Nowadays, instead of storing data on a local drive, many people are opting for cloud storage. Here I have shown you the diagram of how the cloud storage will be look alike. But what is actually a cloud storage? A cloud storage is an internet service where the data is stored on an external server with help of internet. The data saved on cloud, the data saved on cloud storage cannot be destroyed easily, and we can access it from anywhere. The example of cloud storage is Dropbox, OneDrive and Google Drive. As we all are using our Gmail account, Google will provide us one space which is named as Drive, on which we can save different files and folders. And these files and folders are accessible anywhere in the world where we are having a good connectivity with internet and the devices which can access the internet with help of it. Now we will move further to the advantages of cloud storage. The first advantage of cloud storage is we can store files on cloud storage from any device or location. The second advantage is cloud storage is much faster than the conventional storage devices. Third is we can allow any account to view specific files and documents. Means we can give them the permissions to view, we can give the permission to another user to view particular files and documents. And the fourth point is we can store important document on cloud storage and can access it with help of username and password, such as our Gmail. Now in this part of the video, we have learned about secondary memory and the devices which work as secondary storage of computer system. We learned about the magnetic disk, that is hard disk drive, and cloud storage. Thank you.